light. It's that Eastside Johnny Big Redemption light. No, I'm talking about. Hold up.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Get out the way, get out the way.
And we come to you from one of the truly iconic stadiums in the NFL as you get a look at Lambeau Field here in Green Bay, Wisconsin. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Atlanta Falcons and the Green Bay Packers. It's the final 3 weeks of the season. Still plenty to play for here as we're underway in week 15. Gets fielded in the end zone. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. They go play action here on first down. This one complete to Mohamed Sanu. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. 23 yards on the play.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And that play is able to get on the run, and was still accurate throwing the football.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. First time they've hooked up here. Good for 17 and a first down.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
Flushed out right. So this is Shepherd on the catch. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchup.
They'll look to throw again. Getting it out left side to Sanu. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 15 yards through the air on a first down. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And he's going to get it inside the 10 to the 7-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
On second down, Freeman. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Devontae Freeman with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Falcons take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Now here's Bryant to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their own 23. Now the Georgia Southern man, this is Jerick McKinnon, and he stopped immediately there. J.J. Watt, the one that gets him down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is, and really a lot of the time they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance, they're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
And again, the run defense stout this time. He maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage, but no more. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
There's an example of good situational football being played by a defense. They understood where the third down play was, the down and distance, and made sure that they didn't get anywhere near that, bringing up fourth down.
Yeah, they were sniffing out that marker, didn't want to let him get close to there, and now a likely three and out to start.
Yeah, I love the way they rallied to the football and got to him and made sure he didn't give up much run after catch.
On fourth down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. Back deep, Tariq Cohen. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Oh, he'll field it in the end zone. 62 yards on the punt that time. Wow. And the Falcons will get it first and 10 from deep in their own territory. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. Oh, he's got a little daylight. Devontae Freeman, they're not going to get him. Touchdown, Falcons. Devontae Freeman, 94 yards. And the Falcons are able to show off their quick strike ability. And a pair of rushing touchdowns now for him in the first quarter.
And I'm liking what I'm seeing from his big guys up front because they're winning the leverage game. How many times have we talked about? Low man wins, right? Move the defensive front aside, create those gaps and holes. He's found his way through them for 2 touchdowns.
And after both of those touchdowns, he went right up to that O-line and hit each of them on the helmet.
That's a smart man. You know what else he should do? If this continues, take them all to dinner.
That is caught. He's got it. And the lead will move to 14-0. Now here's Bryant to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. He spins free, and he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points. Get that zero off the board. Rodgers now on first down. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Brian Poole.
Well, if you go by the numbers, you'll find as the temperature goes down, so does the passing efficiency. And now that we're in December, even the routine throws are going to be harder for the quarterbacks. And this one, it winds up getting picked off.
By 90! By 20!
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Swings it out to the flat for Freeman. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Being chased out left. And he Falcons are in for the touchdown.
Well, Brandon, if we go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator, he showed us his script. Didn't show us everything now. He said, here's the script for the game. I think everything's going according to plan in a big way. Three drives, three touchdowns.
Yeah, that's about as good. That is as good as you can do, I guess. So, well done.
Yeah, well done indeed. Tremendous execution.
Now here's Bryant to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one.
And he is going to go down. They sack him on the final play of the first quarter. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Second quarter about to get underway with the Packers in possession. So after the sack, they'll come up on a still manageable second and 13. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And left side here, it's Graham. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
That was an okay hookup there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
On play action, Rodgers escaping the pressure right. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, it's looking like another three and out here, and at some point, got to be able to put together a drive to keep your defense from having to go right back out on the field. I feel like things are starting to unravel a little bit, and we're not even at halftime.
They're going to line up to go for this on fourth down. Rodgers stays on the field. They do go for it. It's Rodgers. And he finds Jimmy Graham. And they're able to get this one across the 35. They get 11 there on 4th and 10. Didn't get it by much, but it is a first down. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got it up over the 40 to the 41. Second and four.
Let's talk about football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains.
Partner, those are back-to-back six-yard runs, and if they're going to continue to get those types of plays, shoot, you just keep running the same stuff, don't you?
That was first and 10 and second and four. Now first and 10 again. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there in good defensive position, able to affect the play.
Rodgers again here on second and 10. Rolling to his right. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. He turned that into a nice gain. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down. Sets up a first and goal.
To me, this isn't even a question. I think that they'll go. When they have a chance to put a dent in the lead, even with a whole second half to play, I think they have to do it. This isn't a risk. This is a necessity.
After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Solid coverage on the play by Devondre Campbell. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal?
Four down. 319.
Now it's Rodgers. Eluding the pressure right. This is caught. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Devontae Adams hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Packers make some inroads here on that deficit. You always worry about the plant foot in the snow, but no problems there. And they'll cut the lead to 21-7. Bullock out now to kick this one away. On the return, it's Tariq Cohen. Oh, look at the juke. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
It's hauled in by Shepard. Space to maneuver at the 40. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
As long as you go through your proper reads and progressions, the drag route can be one of those old reliable plays because usually it's good for a good chunk of yardage, as we just saw there.
And those guys like it, right? They can get the ball with a full head of steam.
Especially against man coverage, because man coverage, you're typically running away from someone and not worried about traffic coming out on the other end.
Call it a loss of two on the play, and it'll be second and 12. Now a handoff. It's Freeman. Runs over it. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and they're going to have a third down. You talked about the need for them to establish the run early. They've been able to do that here in the first half.
And that means that the whole offense has adopted that attitude and that persona. We're going to take care of this young quarterback. Let's all get together and run it and take the pressure off.
Looking to throw. Flush to his right. He goes underneath to Freeman. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. It'll be a pickup of only a yard, and that'll bring up fourth down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. And they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. Dan Quinn's guys unable to come through there on fourth down. And this defense is going to get the football back near midfield, right at the 48. So good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10. Working from the gun, Rodgers. Throw left side, complete. It's Graham. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice gain right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them. No gain on that run. And while the team is down, there's still time to come back and win the football game. If I'm the offensive coordinator, though, I got to think about moving at a faster pace and maybe opening things up a little bit, throwing it a little bit more.
And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Up from his linebacker spot, Deion Jones making the play. The clock rolls as the Packers look to hurry things up. Now Rodgers throwing on second down. Flushed out right. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously one that should have been caught. They've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
And that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. And that is not going to go for Bullock. It's left to the upright. No good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. Looking for Shepherd deep. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left. They were trying to get it there to Sterling Shepherd. And now it's second down. Here's second and 10 now from the 29. They'll throw now on the final play. Looking deep for Julio. This is caught inside the 15. And he's going to get this down inside of Green Bay's 15-yard line. So we have reached halftime now with the visiting Falcons out on top. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, not too many breaks ahead according to the radar. More snow on the horizon as we are back underway in half number two. The Packer offense now ready to get back onto the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this is
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. They'll run it now out of the gun. Space to run past the 20. And he's going to get it all the way down to the 10-yard line. 25 yards, the pickup there, and also a first down.
We could talk about bend but don't break all we want, but the defense now, we're going to find out just how flexible and pliable they really are. Can they bounce back after that type of a run, that type of momentum against them, and find a way to slow down this offense?
They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play, and that'll bring up a second and goal. He'll get it up the middle, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. We've become so accustomed to it, you sort of take it for granted.
You really do, but he is so good that every team in his division every year is trying to make sure they draft people charged with trying to block J.J. Watt. So far, hasn't been too successful.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Ricardo Allen with a pick. And he'll be stopped shy of the 15 at the 14-yard line on the return. first possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. That throw good for four. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. They'll drop the throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay, because the second part of that is, if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Looking for Shepherd deep. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And he'll take it across midfield to the 46-yard line.
Man, we see a lot of quarterbacks try and do this. They get out of the pocket, they get in trouble, and they try and force the ball into their star receiver to make a play, sometimes whether he's open or not. And I think this time, it was definitely an or not.
So after the INT, it's Rodgers. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Tech McKinley in there to sack him. And that is 10 for him now on the year. On second down, here's Rodgers. Flush to his right. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. He turned that into a nice game. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down.
Partner was a definite passing down, but he was able to leak out and pick up some good yardage, even though the coverage was excellent. Maybe it's not exactly how they drew it up, but he still got a big chunk of yardage on second down.
And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man, and you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Rodgers going up top. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. Picked off by Brian Poole. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. On fourth down, that turned out like a punt. Maybe he was better defensively there just to knock it down.
And you know they go over those situations. All right, fourth down, where's the ball? Where would we get the ball? But instinct takes over, and when it's in the air, they just go and get it. So it's hard to get on him for intercepting it. But the smart play would have been what you suggested. Knock it down and take over in a deeper position.
They'll run with Freeman here to begin the drive. And they'll get him down up past the 15, just shy of the 20. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards. It moves the sticks.
Another good run there, and now we're seeing an offense that's imposed its will on a defense. When we talk about that all the time, what does it really mean? It means that the guys on the offensive line, they think they can do whatever they want. They're in the huddle saying, run it again. Give us another chance to smack someone and create some space. On the defensive side of the ball, not only have they imposed their will against you, you're almost powerless to figure out what you're doing there, but you got to keep your spirit up at the same time. And they're taking that, too.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now a play fake here on first down. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. This defense figured out something in the locker room. That's two third-quarter picks now.
And you just wonder, did he get too comfortable in the locker room himself? His team has the lead. Take care of the football. He's putting him in jeopardy right now.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. There he goes inside the 30. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a first down.
Obviously a big play was needed, and you can see his eyes light up as he realized there's absolutely no one in front of him. And he takes off and goes a long way. Not only does he pick up a first down, but a big gain to boot.
Rodgers now on first down. Ooh, caught by Cobb. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Graham. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Keanu Neal. And a short return will be stopped inside the 10 at the 8-yard line. Well, when you start thinking of guys that are in the mix for Defensive Player of the Year, I think you use him as Exhibit A. Maybe he's not the leading guy right now, but he's at least on the periphery and deserves to be in the discussion.
And because of that, he's looking at a game today where, in order to make that big move and maybe become the guy, he needs multiple takeaways, multiple big plays, things that get our attention and reverberate for weeks to come.
Devontae Freeman, they're not going to get him. And he cuts middle, creating space. Touchdown, Falcons. Devontae Freeman, his third touchdown of the game, number 14 on the year. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. Bryant's extra point up and good. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Now here's Bryant to kick it away. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Packers offense now heading back out onto the field. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. Throwing now is Rodgers. Buying time to his left. Now he's going to go deep down the left side. This is caught inside the 15. And he takes this thing way down into Atlanta territory. That'll put him at 77 yards receiving for the ball game. It's a first down. Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. Forced out to his left. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Randall Cobb, his 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Packers get a score closer. And Holly clanks it off the right upright, and it's no good. Bullock out now to kick this one away. This is taken at his 4. Gets around him. And now the spin. It'll bring it back to just about the 25. Call it the 24-yard line. Here are the Falcons as their offense heads back onto the field.
And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it big-time jaunt? Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
This is Freeman on first and 10.
And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Well, Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech.
And now a 10th carry for Freeman. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Looking downfield for Jones. That's caught inside the 20. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Mohamed Sanu, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Falcons will extend their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is it bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Packers off. Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now a play fake. Rodgers. They'll roll him out right. Oh, wide open. Complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A gain of 39 that time.
45, 45, 45. Come on. Hey, check 26.
Look at this. They go play action here on first down. Flushed out right. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, not much there that time. And I think we were both wondering, once he got out of the box, whether he just throw the ball away and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
Here. Jumbo!
On play action, it's Rodgers. Let's it fly deep for Kyle. And this is caught inside the 5. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. They'll try and run with McKinnon. And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown. Jerick McKinnon, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Packers make some inroads here on that deficit. Throwing is Rodgers, and he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite, but in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free, and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a 2-point conversion, all that extra, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just given them a jersey, but a seat on the bench as well. Whatever do you need, you've got it, because the way they're stringing things together and creating that distance between them and their opponent, it's really hard to narrow that gap. And the other part is they're taking their spirit away from them, too.
And now they're just looking to add to that total. And this will be taken across midfield and into Green Bay territory. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. He'll drop to throw. Dancing to his left. Now he's going to send this one deep right side. And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons. Devontae Freeman, 48 yards. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. And man, Charles, talk about zinging something in there. Those gloves, they help with one-handed catchers, the fun stuff. Any padding for a rocket like that?
One would think so, but I'll guarantee you this, after that throw, his hands will hurt later. Not right now in the moment. He's just feeling good about catching it.
Yeah, a little stinger, but a touchdown. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Packers get set to go. Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their 25-yard line.
Zone.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Brian Poole that time there to get a hand on it.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
They'll hit Whitaker on the flat. 12 yards there as they move the chains. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. For a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Throw left side complete to Hogan. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8. Now they got to get to the line quickly. And again, it's Rodgers. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. That's going to be caught. And he just falls short down at the 1 yard line. A big play there. Rodgers to Adams. And even 60 yards. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. And a late score here in this one. So now Rodgers will lead the Packers up to go for two. To throw is Rodgers. The quick slant caught. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. Bullock out now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They are clicking on all cylinders. They seem to be just scoring at will right now, and that's why they've opened up this big lead.
You know, we always talk about getting into the zone, and all athletes are seeking that, aren't they? But everything is working for them. Every move they make works. It clicks, and they are on.
Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. They give him a gain of 38.
And they just hit another big completion there, and I think in days gone by in the NFL, you might have asked, is this a little bit of overkill? Is this rubbing it in? I don't think people feel the same way nowadays.
It's the age-old argument. Then you could say on the other side, if you're going to get angry about it, stop it, right?
Go ahead and stop me.
And this is caught inside the 5. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. A big play there. His first touchdown on the year. And the Falcons will extend their lead.
The Falcons are going to leave the offense out there. They'll go for two. They'll try and run with Freeman. And he is not going to get in there. He stops short of the goal line, and the lead is going to stay right where it is. Now here's Bryant to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now trotting out there, the Packers getting ready to go. They're down big here late. I don't know, you just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once, we were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
We just saw another example of really good defensive football, which has led to the cushion that they have in this game. Got to him once again, knocked him on the ground, forced an incompletion.
Yeah, they've set the tone. It's one thing to set the tone, another to come in here on the road and set the tone. Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Back to the air on second down. It's Rodgers escaping the pressure right. He's going to let it fly. And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Keanu Neal. And they will finally stop him as he's down to the 40-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. And Jones has it over the middle. That one goes for 36 yards. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They come up in an offset eye. They'll run here with Freeman. And he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2-yard line. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Second and goal, and the lone man in the backfield is Freeman. They'll look to run with Freeman. And he gets in. Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Falcons turn that interception into a touchdown. And now once again, they'll line up to go for two. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Complete at the one. And he will get into the end zone again. And he seems to have a nose for it as he gets both the touchdown and the two-point conversion. And this one's going to be covered up by the Packers hands team. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
And we will get a timeout with two ticks left. When we see another great performance like this out of Aaron Rodgers, you have to chuckle thinking that his only FBS offer was a walk-on at Illinois.
And now he's the pride of Butte Junior College, of course at Cal. And I remember watching him play at Cal, and he would run 7-on-7 drills. Angry if the ball ever hit the ground, and it didn't do it.
And this is going to be caught. So it affects the final score, not the outcome, but it is a late touchdown here on the game's final play. Doesn't affect the outcome, but hey, nice job there to put it in the end zone for the final play.
Could it affect other things? Sometimes these types of scores are ones that we don't consider big at the time. Then later on we find out maybe that was a tiebreaker.
Yeah. Under pressure now, and he's going to go down.
sack back around the 8.